Hello, I'm Alice Jackson, and welcome to another installment of Grand Design's Breaking Barriers, Building Bridges. During this episode, we will explore the role of dance as a collaborator in African-American Black music. Black dance has styles whose origins include the tribal dances of Africa, the slave dances of the West Indies, dances of America's Deep South, the Harlem social dances of the 1920s, and the jazz dance of Broadway musicals. More recently, defining dance has broadened to include the urban black dance forms of breakdancing and hip-hop, which have been recognized for their artistry and expressiveness. As slave labor began in the 1500s, Africans brought their dances to America and the Caribbean islands. The dance styles of many African groups fused with European dances, forming an expression of African America. Dance has always been an integral part of life in Africa and in America. Dance helped enslaved Africans to connect with their homeland, keeping their cultural traditions alive. Joining us today via Zoom is Mary Nelson with My Sister's Keeper and the J.L. Thompson Dance Ensemble. Mary will share her wealth of knowledge on the expression of dance as a collaborator in African-American Black music. But first, let's take a look at a performance by the dance group My Sister's Keeper.
Thank you. My name is Mary Nelson. The dancers that you saw today are part of a dance ministry called My Sister's Keeper. Now, My Sister's Keeper has probably been around for at least a good year. I started my ministry of dancing with a dance group called J.L. Thompson Dance Ensemble, which has been around for over 20 years. I was one of the original dancers, one of the members for many, many years until probably about a year ago. And then it was a kind of a shift in things. And I hadn't really been dancing because I was taking care of a parent at that time. And my sister, Roslyn Nelson Chestnut, started My Sister's Keeper. So I kind of help them with choreography when I can, when I'm in town, of course. I'm a flight attendant with one of the greatest airlines. Sorry, got to put that in there. Southwest Airlines. And so over 20 years ago, we started a dance ministry. Like I said, became a nonprofit organization. They're still around. I also over a dance ministry at my church, which is King Baptist. So that's about me, about dancing. I took dance off and on throughout my life, from a young child to an adult. And I like to take that and incorporate that into the ministry. My greatest influence is the Spirit of God. And that's where I get all my inspiration and for what the type of dancing that we do. I also incorporate sign language into a lot of our ministry. Many, many years ago, probably over 30 years ago, yes, I'm dating myself, I worked for, volunteered and worked for a group home that I was responsible for the daily activities for two young adults that were 16 that were hearing, but they were mute. And I taught them life skills as much as they taught me life skills as well. And they didn't have a real way of communication other than pointing. And I thought one of the best things that they, to help them learn to communicate in the world as they go out into the world, would be to have sign language. So we took sign language together. And then I took that skill on into my career as law enforcement for the Denver Police Department. And I used to do some interpretation. I continued my education that way. So through dance, one of the groups of people that are usually left out are those that are hearing impaired. So I thought, why not incorporate what we're doing along with our dance? I always say traditions change because people change, but the dance is still the same. The movements are still the same. People are still dancing, using African movements to tell a story. And that's really what dance is for me. And I think the group is about to tell a story, to help people that are going through something to be able to not only hear, but see that interpretation of a song. And I believe African dance has always been a part of that and will always remain a part of any kind of dance that you do.
Love you. Banga, I love you. Ashe, ashe.
and I could go way, 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 way back, but I'm gonna stay with the confounds of just Colorado here. And Cleo has been a true inspiration, I think, in every art form. I have taken a couple of classes there on and off over the years, many moons ago. And I think to be able to go, she's an icon here in Colorado. And if anyone's never had a chance to go see the performance she's put on, you should really go out and check and see it. It's fantastic. It's marvelous. And instead of going way back, I'm going to just use her as one of my also most inspirations.
Thank you.
of people teach step by step. Okay, let me show you this move. Then they go into the next move. I like to take it in chunks. And I don't want you to know the whole thing, but for kids, they pick up quicker. And when you have younger people, their movements have a little bit, especially at our age of the dance ministry, some of their movements are a little more fluid than ours. So when I'm dealing with young people, I think I learned from them. I'm like, okay, how's this best going to work for you? Let me show it to you. And a lot of them can mimic it like that. And so it's a different process. So it's like, okay, this is what we're going to do today. Let me show it to you. And then I'll show it. There's like, oh, that's cool, but can we do this? So I want them to incorporate what they know and what they're feeling so that the dance is not mine, it becomes ours. And I do that with the adults as well, but a little bit differently in the sense that sometimes they're, you know, there's sometimes some of the women have never danced before in their lives because of the, and part of their ministry is this is the way they want to minister. So they're like, I don't have anything. And once they get used to it, it's like, oh yeah, I do. I had a thought about this. And I'm like, okay, let's see what does that look like? Or they tell me, it's like, can you show me, this is what I'm thinking. I'm like, is this what you're thinking? And I'll try the move. And it's like, yeah, that's what I want to do. I think that goes there. And so it becomes, the piece doesn't become mine. It becomes ours for God. Even with looking at today, I saw a podcast earlier today, and the way that he kind of explained things of how things are going on today is not a change. It's something that has always been about since the beginning of time, from slavery, all the uprisings. And so these black faces that you see and, you know, dubbing the music and to the uprise of today and the unsettlement people that they consider it. It's one of those things where it didn't start yesterday. It didn't start today. It started a long time ago, and it's going to continue until till all people have all rights, all equal rights. I think all dance is beautiful. I don't care if you're talking about African dance, you're talking tap, you're talking modern, you're talking hip hop, you're talking, you know, your dancers that are on the streets, you know, your break dancers or whatever you want to call it today. All dance is beautiful. And if you ever look at all dance, it's all intertwined with each other. From all these shows that have been on television that have come and gone and going to come and go, from your Cleos to your, I can't think of all the dancers' names, your Alvin Haley's and all these wonderful dance people that have been out there for many, many years. And they're always going to be around. Dance is one thing, if nothing else, brings people together. No matter what kind of dance it is, go to a wedding. You will see, no matter what kind of wedding it is, the dance brings people together. And no matter what it is, it will always bring people together.
While race has been an insurmountable barrier in dance and music, many of the dances of the plantations moved onto the stage through minstrel shows, which introduced black dance to a larger, mainly white audience in the 1800s. However, while opportunities for black dances and music were limited in America, many performers found fame abroad. This concludes our installment of Breaking Barriers, Building Bridges, the role of African dance and expression. Please remember to tune in again as we continue the series, A Journey of Our History, Heritage, Culture, and Triumphs. Thank you to our special guests, Mary Nelson, the Awade Drum and Dance, My Sister's Keeper, and Cleo Parker Robinson Dance, for being a part of this episode. Whatever you do, do not stop the music and the dance.